Good afternoon.
Good
How are
afternoon.
You? I'm all good. So good. Should I start or something, or I still will need to wait for everyone to join in?
Ma'am, should we start?
It's about 65.
Yes.
You think we could wait till 3:05?
Yes, ma'am.
Because I just sent out to all the the present people who've got admission, all the candidates. I just sent it out to them, so okay, they ma'am. Must be trying to get on.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am, for 5 minutes I'll be talking. Then yes. I'll be setting my camera on a stabilizer for the video.
Okay.
So then I will be winding up in half an hour, and I'll be giving 15 minutes for the students for questions.
Done. Wonderful. Wonderful. Okay.
Yeah.
Wonderful. How is the business going?
Ma'am, too you're busy.
I know you had to take time out to do this. Today must have been lots of orders, being a Saturday, no?
Yes, ma'am. Seriously. I'm actually have to start now. Many chocolates thing, you know. It's very difficult to start chocolate in the house because the temperature is not supporting me.
Oh, okay. Wow, yeah. Truly, it's gone extra.
Yeah.
A marble table.
Let's see. I'll see something. How to handle the chocolate thing, because I like my cakes more into chocolate garnishes than just fondant and all.
Oh, okay. So tell me, how are you delivering everything? Are you?
No, I have. When it is a cake or something, I prefer going by myself. I take it on my own.
Okay.
Because after every delivery, I have the habit of calling the client and asking, how was the cake and how did you like it?
Okay.
Just to see, what is the feedback. But till now, at least 98% I got a good feedback. Till now.
Very good.
1% was wrong, but just because I had to use the vegan butter and sugar, and the dough was not that good because it was not a short crust dough.
Right.
It's a different thing only. That's not your fault. It's a different thing only. I should have told you first.
what kind of flour did you use for the vegan?
I was actually using everything vegan, organic flours and all, which comes in a packet. Organic sugar means vegan butter, but the only thing, the dough is very hard to handle.
Yeah, it won't come as crumbly.
Yeah. I just tried and the dough came when I baked it, it just broke. It's very hard. When I was doing on the ship thing also, it's the only thing which is super hard.
Okay.
And I was the dough cookie man and all. I had to do all this. My God.
You know, there's, Jason, one flour that we are using, which you must have seen when we did it for Rebus. Sabudana flour.
The tapioca flour.
Yeah, it works really well. Only it's a pain because you have to go to the chakki man after he has finished and cleaned everything. Then he can grind it for you, and he doesn't grind less than 50 kilos or 25 kilos.
Yes, ma'am. 50.
I think 25 kilos.
I guess 50.
Yeah,
25
but
kilos.
It goes very fast. Yeah, it's really a very good flour to work with. We do that. They make all the stuff for me from that flour.
I take it from you then, indirectly.
Yes.
It's 3:06, ma'am. Should I?
Yes.
Start.
Yes, please.
Okay, I'll just put my. I'll be telling everyone what I'm going to do. Okay. Okay. So good afternoon, everyone. I'm Chef Jason here. So today's class is not about fancy dessert or hectic garnishes or amazing decor around the cake. This is a class. Is something that I actually wanted from the time I started pastry. This is not a class where you can get on a YouTube or Google search. It's very important that what is the construction of a cake, the basic of the cake, how to catch a piping bag, how to catch the palette knife, why you should not soak the sponge of the down layer so much, and not what is the whipping cream, how to use it, which type to use it. All this is never covered on Google or YouTube. That's the only thing that you get in experience. Okay, so I'll be covering, and I'll be even telling you, ask me questions which you cannot find on Google. Do not ask me why is this cream has more fat than this cream. Okay, that you can definitely get on Google. Okay, so ask me why this cream should not be whipped at this particular speed. This is something they won't tell. So it's like this. Okay, so ma'am, sir, I'll be connecting my cell phone on the stabilizer. Sure. So I'll show them how it. So let me talk about the sponge first. Okay. I'll just put on a stabilizer and I'll stop.
Yes, yes, yes.
India, Sweden.
Okay, he's come back on.
Yes.
Lovely.
Okay. So, ma'am, can you see me?
Yes, yes, yes.
And listen to me, yes?
Yes, you're audible.
Yes.
So, yes, the most important thing is the baking of the sponge. So, guys, let me tell you, the baking of the sponge is why you should use a butter, not oil. Why oil, not butter? It's a different perspective. Okay. So how it starts? If you put the oil in the dough and you mix it, when you bake it, the sponge will become a mountain, not flat. So whenever you cut the sponge, the top part of the mountain gets wasted. So if you use butter instead, you'll get a flat sponge. Right. And yes, do understand what is the meaning of soft butter and melted butter. When you use melted butter, it's a liquid form. That soft butter is like a creamy form. Okay. So yes. Now cutting of the sponge. As you can see, the sponge is cut depending on how thick you want the sponge. Let it be very thick. Let it be very thin. If it's a thick sponge, you see to that you actually soak it very well. And if it's a thin sponge, you see to that you soak it little, but the mousse should be more. Okay, so when you cut it, you will come to you are not eating a sponge, but the flavor you should not compromise. Okay, so let's see now. Talk about the folding of the sponge. So when you make everything together, let it be flour, let it be you raise the egg and everything. The folding of the sponge should be cut and fold. Most important aspect of cutting and folding is just don't. Gently, nicely, because whatever you're whipping should not go down. Okay, and last and not the least, when you're putting the batter, you put it nicely and layer it in such a way that batter, the air should not go off. When the air goes, forget the sponge will never rise. Okay, so let me show the construction of a cake with a sponge. Okay, so first you take a normal sponge, put it down inside. Okay, you take the sugar syrup, you soak it very less. Very important why to soak it very less, because it helps you to pick it up. And if you are making an alcoholic cake or something, never soak the down sponge in a very high alcohol taste, because whenever you eat a cake, your tongue should not get coated with the alcohol. You will never ever get the other mousse taste. Okay? So, yeah. As now I'm going to show you, the camera is coming as close as just super less. Okay? That's it. Super less. You keep it. Now, the piping. Now, people will be like, sir, now you have thought everything about this, but how to catch a piping leg? That's more important because lefties are catching like this, like this, like this. It's not about the comfortable level, it's about the proper technique. It's like push and press. Can you see this? It's a hold. It's a hold. Okay? This is press. And here, the top part, my left hand, when you press it, you just press the moves from this part to this part. Okay? So let's go. Super easy. I press. It's empty. So now I open this part. I fill it. I close it again. Then I go again. Again, I'll show you the same thing. Again. Okay. This is how you always be generous with your moves. Okay. And I'll be covering up how to make a proper moves and which types of moves can you be making. Then the other sponge. So now, this is not a fruit cake, okay? So what do you do to make it very stable? You press it nicely. Many of them use their hand. Many of them use the cake board. Put the cake board and just press it. But cake board is 99% sure that all the possible layers are clean. Let it be mousse, let it be a sponge. Everything has a perfect layer. So, yes, now this part has to be soaked very well. Okay. So, this sugar syrup, what I have made, it's an authentic one. It's not like a sugar and water mixed. No. It's a sugar, 2% of sugar. It's a 2:1. Always 2:1. You take the 2:1 sugar and 1:1 water. Nicely boil it with 1 cinnamon and star anise and a whole orange cut into half with the skin inside the sugar syrup. So you don't only get the sugar syrup flavor, but you get the spices and the fruity as well. Okay, this is the way you soak it. Check this out. It should not be that soggy that you just put your finger, it goes inside. It has to come back up. Put. See, it's coming. Put. This is means you have perfectly soaked the sponge. Okay, so let's do the other round. One more on top. Last punch. Guys, never compromise with your weight, okay? Always weigh your moves when you're putting it. When you're doing a pastry, not a cake, when you're doing a pastry. Okay, pastry is that big frame. You make the whole pastry on it and then you cut it for 1 kg, 1/2 kg like this. Many of them have a misconception what is a pastry. Is pastry that small? That big, the whole frame is pastry. So yes, and now this part, the soaking. 10%, 50%, and 30%. Okay, the soaking of the sponge. 10, 50, 30. Why? Because if you're using this as a cover for a fondant or something, it should not get that soggy. The fondant will lose your color or something. So please, it's just super 30%. Each and every part, okay? Each and every part. And yes, if you want to put alcohol in the sugar syrup, you can. But never soak a lot in the bottom layer. Okay, check this out. Nicely soaked. And you see, it just come on top, not like the previous one. Okay? Because it is 30% soak, not 50. Okay, so I should not remove this now. But just for you, just see how the layering is. Okay? The layering of the cake. The mousse, when you press, the mousse goes out. Okay? So now let me show you how to poke a cake and how to catch a pellet. So let this thing go in the fridge and I'll tell you which cake has to come up. So yes. The most important thing to learn a coating with a pellet knife is how to catch a pellet. Okay? Straight, this finger is not like this. Straight and hold it straight in. Okay? And always learn your coating from a small cake. Small cake is the hardest one. Big cake, you get a very big base, very big front because it's big. Smaller one, you need to practice hard. That is why I made a small cake to show how difficult it is. So let me get the turntable and I'll show you how to fold it. Okay. So this is the small cake. Same mousse. Okay. Put here. Okay. Then put here. Super easy. Okay. First, always start. Just go slowly on top. It's not about how fast you can do it, it's like how clean you can do it. Okay. Now check this out. This is a frozen cake. Okay. This is how you remove a cake. Press this part, go down, move it on top, place it here. Okay. So now let's coat the edges. See, you can see it's all broken here and there. But how to make it proper is a real pastry man job. Okay? See this. Now, the pattern is pull, push. Pull, push. Pull, push. Pull, push. Pull. So once you finish the whole thing, always have a clean cloth with you. Always have a clean cloth. So once you finish this thing, take a mousse, put excess mousse on top always. Now check this out. Just slow coating. Now this is known as crumb coating. The meaning of crumb coating is we just coat the cake so the crumb can be not visible. Okay, nicely done. Now can you see the upper part? This is known as edges. The most hard cake is the hard cake or the square cake. So let's do the top part. I just go fast now. See, go like this, I come like this, I go, I come, go, come, go, come. Now always have a clean cloth with you. Can you, so you can clean your palette knife with it. explain it now. Have a speed like in 1 minute, you can coat the cake. In 1 minute. Okay. Now check this out, guys. This part. How to get it straight. Just go like this. 1 smooth edge. Now, next. 1 more smooth edge. Can you see this now? Why is this edge so important? So because when you glaze a cake, so let me go in the theory now. So let this thing get frozen because I'm going to glaze it. So this is the way you just lift it. I can lift this thing just because the sponge down is not soaked. Can you see this? So put your finger here, put this thing, rub it on the, you see this edges, it should not get destroyed. And I just place it over here, the same cake board, and I'm going to freeze it. And you press it like this, and you pull it. Okay? So let this thing go on the fridge. I'll clean up my head. Let's speak about. Okay, so let me get the camera to myself. I'll be speaking on the cream and types of cream. Okay. Okay, guys, so I made all the possible moves. So I made all the possible notes on how to coat a cake and which cream you need to use. So which cream I'll tell you. So not let's start with the cake. Let's start with the mousse what I use. Okay. The chocolate mousse what I just made. Okay. For chocolate mousse or for fruit mousse. To make a great mousse, always follow the ratio of ganache and the cream. Okay. The ganache that you make. I use the ratio of 1 kg and 1 kg. That is what you get a ganache. 1 kg of cream, heavy cream, and 1 kg of dark chocolate. Okay. Then you cook it nicely. You cook it in such a way that it become, you cook the milk first, then you put it in the broken chocolates. That's the way you get the ganache. And the whipped cream, how much the cream has to be whipped, which cream you are using. So there are 2 types of cream which we use in the industry. One is the imported, which is Allen Wire. I don't want to take any brand name or something, but yes, Allen Wire is one, and the other one is the rich topping that is locally used for industrial uses. The problem with the rich topping is it is already sweet. And you can whip it for how long you want. If you still get whipped, it won't tear. And now, the Allen Wire cream, where all the big chefs, you can say, are actually practicing on it because it's the most hardest cream to practice on. Because you have to know how much to whip it. If you over whip this cream, it will tear and the cream will lose the water. And all the fat will come together and this becomes your butter. Which we don't want. We are already using a butter. We want the cream. So that's the way. When you're making a mousse, your cream texture has to be very good. If it's semi-whipped, it's amazing. This mousse is the actual chocolate mousse. You use chocolate, sabayo, and cream. Follow the same pattern. Chocolate, melted. Sabayo is when you actually use the whole egg yolk and sugar together. You whip it, you get sabayo. You put the melted chocolate in the sabayo. Do follow this. Melted chocolate in the sabayo and not in the cream. Okay? So melted chocolate in the sabayo. Nicely fold it. And then all of this you will add in cream. Which is semi-whipped. see to that the semi whip is not over whipped. And if it's over whipped, the cream, the imported cream that we use, will get granulated. And the meaning of mousse is when you put in your mouth, it has to just get liquidified and the smooth texture. And when you do the granulated mousse, you will get the grains on the tongue, which is not good. Okay, that's how you use it. So let me tell you about chocolate cakes, fruit cakes, and mold cakes. Okay, as I showed you a chocolate cake in front of me, the ratio was sponge, cream, sponge, sugar syrup, cream, sponge, sugar syrup, cream, and sponge and sugar syrup. You get me? Sponge, I put the sugar syrup, then the mousse. Sponge, sugar syrup, then the mousse, and the top part is just sponge and sugar syrup. This is the mousse cake. And now, if you want to make a fruit cake, this is the pattern. Take the sponge, you soak it in the sugar syrup. You make the mousse. How do you make the mousse is most very important. You just don't take the fruit, chop it, and put in the cream. No. You take the fruit, you cook it, little bit of sugar, little bit of flavor. For example, I'm making a mango basil mousse. I'll cook the basil and the mango together. Okay, together. Sometimes chefs are also trying the mango basil mousse, like cook the basil in the cream so it can incorporate the flavor. Okay, then they make it. There are both the ways. Okay, I don't want my basil to be that strong, so I want my mango to be that strong, or just a pinch of basil in your mouth. That's how you make it. So you cook the mango and basil together and you keep it for chill, and then after chilling you put the whole puree in the whipped cream and then you fold it nicely. See to that it should not be hot, because once the whipped cream gets melted with the puree, it will never get whipped. It will just keep on getting liquid. Okay, you need to actually put in the fridge bag and whip it. So don't take your time when you're making a cake, because there's someone who is going to make a memory by eating your cake. And yes, now the layering of the cake. Sponge sponge with sugar with mango mousse, and now on the mango mousse you put chopped mangoes. When you put chopped mangoes, when you cut it, when you eat, you get the mango mousse with the chunks of mango, which is a delight. Okay, so yes, now sponge, sugar syrup, mango mousse, mango chop. Now again, sponge, sugar syrup, mango mousse, mango chop on top. So you make a two layers like this, and on top just a sponge and sugar syrup. And please do not cheat with the mousse. You are going to even crumb coat with the same mango mousse. Okay, not some different, because if it's mango, it will be full mango. Okay. Now, the best part, when now it's a trend, people want to use molds. Okay. So I have made a cake on molds. Okay. So how do I actually use a chocolate mousse in a molded cake? So yes, of course, you can do that. It's not that hard. You can use any mold cakes. So yes, I made a chocolate cake, nice, super delicious. But now how to pipe the cream in the mold? What do you use is a gelatin. You make the gelatin hot, you put in the mousse, and then the whole mousse will get liquidified. It will never change the taste, it will never change the smoothness, but it will change the texture. Okay, but check this out. I have made the molded cake. Okay, this is a different cake. How do I get this bubble thing on top? It's a mold piece, but how do I get it that clean? It's just because the cream is not hard cream. I have packed it. It's a liquid cream that I use. Liquid mousse with gelatin, and then you get this picture. It's super easy. Cake making is easy. It's most of my experiment. And the molds are, what I use is this mold. Nice mold. I'm not advertising it. It's just the way I'm saying I would use. I've actually got many molds. But the most important thing, how to even make this mold cake. Okay, many of them just fill the whole mousse and then they put the sponge on top. No, that's wrong. Okay, you use the same pattern. Let it be a mousse cake, let it be a chocolate cake, let it be a fruit cake. The pattern is same, but here the pattern is different for the mousse cake. It starts differently. You put a mousse first down, then you put a sponge on top. Okay, so how do you use it? You actually put the mousse inside. Okay, chill it for a little while because when you're putting sponge, the sponge should not go inside. Okay, mousse, chill it, put a sponge. Again, mousse, chill it, a sponge. Mousse, chill and sponge. If you want fruit, take the same way. On the sponge, you put fruits. Then again, mousse. It's like this. So on the mold cake, it's completely different. Start opposite. You put mousse, then you sponge. It's not like a different other cakes where you put sponge first as a base, then you put the mousse. It's a different cake because you need to get the mousse on top, not the sponge. Okay? So, yes, I have finished it. Now, let's talk about alcohol. How do you use the alcohol? Whenever you use the alcohol, you can use it in the ganache, you can use it in the syrup, or you can use it in the mousse, any which place. But alcohol cakes, you need to be very clever, because I do understand everybody loves alcohol, but the most important part is when you eat, it should not spice up. You should not cry like it's coming too much from your mouth. It should be amazing, it should be good. So always, when you put alcohol, put on the second sponge and first sponge. You put your alcohol in the ganache, that's okay. So once you know the ratio of alcohol, don't just keep pouring it, pouring it, pouring it. It is going, people will love the cake, but it will destroy the pan. You will never ever like the cake what you eat. Let it be Baileys, let it be whiskey, let it be rum or anything. People like rum ball, people just spice it up. It's good, but the authentic one is like you get the chocolate as well, you get the brownie as well, you get the rum as well. Everything has to come together. It's not like rum ball means only rum. Even the ball has an element, even the ball has to get mixed. Like, what's the way it is in it? You need to taste it. Okay, now the coating on the cake is, means I already told you how to coat the cake, but the most important thing, if any bakers or pastry men are there, please do coat the cake with a small amount of cake. Take a small layer, 1/4 kg of cake. Start coating it. It's hard work technique. Straight palate, not bad. It will take time, but the method all over the world is same. I don't know what about the lefty. I'm a righty. The lefty one also use the same thing. Okay. So let's do the glazing of the cake. How to do a glazing of the cake? Okay. So, how do you actually make a glaze? I already shown many of the students, but people who are new in this, so let me tell you. I use, it's not a recipe, but I use my own recipe of glazing it. The only thing, it has to come as a mirror glaze. Okay, mirror glaze is not something where you can just see your face. It has to show your skin color in it. That's the reason it's a mirror glaze. That's the reason it's known as mirror. It's not only face, okay? So in the dark glaze, what is there? You can still see my brown color in the dark glaze. That's the known as mirror glaze, okay? So yes, how do I make a glaze? It's super simple. The most important thing is the cooking of the sugar. Once the sugar is cooked perfectly, okay? Once the sugar is cooked perfectly, you put your cocoa powder, okay? You put a cocoa powder, cook it well, you put your chocolate if you want to make a gelatin flavor less. Always keep one thing in mind. If you put your chocolate, you please better make your gelatin level less, because chocolate is already going to make it super thick. Okay, you don't require gelatin at that point. You do require for the coating, but you don't require a lot of gelatin if you're putting a chocolate, dark chocolate slab in a glaze. Put the sugar, put the cocoa powder, put your chocolate, mix it well, keep it in the side. You soak your gelatin in a chilled water. It's a little bit, sheet or something. You always soak a gelatin, the sheet one, in chilled water, and the normal powdered one in a room temperature water. Not a problem. But always just don't throw the gelatin inside. You need to melt it and then throw it inside. The many of them just throwing it. You will get lumps in. You will get, then you have to strain your case. You do have to strain your glass because there's cocoa powder in it, not the fact that there's gelatin. So don't play with the method. Keep the age-old method, let the gelatin get melted and then you use it. It's much better. Okay? So, yes. And then, how do you pour the glaze on the cake? Super important. How do you pour it? We just don't take the hot glaze and pour on the mousse. So now my cake is getting, my cake is inside the fridge. Just, it can get a solid, nice solid texture of the mousse outside. Because when I put the glaze, hot glaze, not hot, the temperature of a glaze is, this is the perfect temperature of your body. This is the temperature. Okay. Once you, means there are many of them who don't have a thermometer, they put the hand in the glaze and they touch it like this. When you get the coldness, means the perfect temperature 30 seconds. Or I have to put the glaze in. If it's too cold, I'm telling you, if you put your glaze on the cake, the glaze will go on the cake and you just set over there. It won't go down. It has to go down. That's the reason it is a glaze. Okay? So, this is a chocolate cake. Okay? Super. Now, I will start glazing it. I've never tried glazing a mold cake till now because this is an experiment for me. Like to experiment. Okay? So, let me get the pellet type of cake. I actually want some mistake to happen over here so that I can tell you what is wrong. Okay, so yes, put this cake on it. Okay. Can you see this? It's hard. Okay. Take this rag. So this part of the glaze is super complicated because it is not at all a straight cake, a round cake, or hard cake. It is everywhere. And how do you glaze it? You glaze it fully and you wait. You keep tapping it like this. So let's see. See, now the problem with this thing, it just came out of the fridge. It just came out of the fridge. It has a condensation on top. So what happens in this, if you put the glaze over it, it will just go out. It will just go out every day. It will never stick on it, okay? So let's try, because I want to show you the mistake of the glazing, okay? Everybody actually be telling you how to glaze it and all, but no one is telling how to rectify the mistake. Okay, so let me see how does it go over here. Always, it is catching. Can you see? It is leaving the gaps. So let's pour. Okay, now this gap is filled. You can't keep the gap filled because it is a pattern on top. You just keep shaking it. Up, right, left. Hey, it's a good glaze, huh, by the way. Good job, Jason. Can you see that? If you see, it is shining. It's not about it's a good glaze or something. It's about the perfect cooking of the sugar. A bubble, and now give it a time. Nicely do everywhere. But this gap should not have glaze in it. Okay, so now you just do like this part. This is the most important thing in glazing. How do you get a perfect boundaries for the cake? Okay. So now I'll tell you how to keep a cake on. press it and you remove the hamper of the cake. Can you see? I've given a good time for it to set. So what happens here is, it will never follow. Now the storage of the glaze cake. Now let me get some beautiful garnishes, very simple garnishes. Always do understand how do you garnish a cake. It's not about you fully put the garnish on top. It's just remaining garnish. Check this out, guys. I didn't make any complex garnishes. Super simple. But how do you use the garnishes is very important. Okay? So now bubble, because this is the first time I'm doing the garnish, so you need to pre-prep, like what to do, what to do, what to do. So yes, okay, let's start. Okay, place one over here. Okay, you place one over here. Okay, this one small. This is the way you need to think. How to play with garnishes. The position of the cake. Okay. Super easy. 1, 2, 3. People will be like, oh, very less garnishes. Guys, it's a classic cake. It's not full cake with cream. No, it has its own identity. It is already in a mold. It has a different shape. So if you put a lot of garnish over it, a lot of decoration, people will never see the design of the cake or something, how you made it. People will only see the garnishes. So basically, you are overlapping the decor of the cake with just a garnishes. So use it carefully, use it wisely. So yes, I'll like to finish my demonstration over here. And now let me give time for all the students who have questions. So let me come close. Okay. Sorry, that was my sister who was helping me out. Okay. So I want some questions. Chef, I would prefer anyone asking me questions over.
Jason, I have a question.
I can't listen to you, sir. Chef, I can't listen to you.
You can't hear me? Give me 1 minute. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? Yes, no? No?
Chef.
Yes, Jason.
You can listen to me?
You can listen to me? Am I audible? No.
Chef, can you listen to me?
We can hear both of you.
Audible, ma'am?
Yeah, can you hear me, Jason? Jason, they can hear you. Can you hear me?
No, ma'am. I can't listen to you, ma'am.
Okay, everyone else is. Can you look at the questions on your phone? I sent you messages.
Ma'am?
I can hear you, Jason. I can hear you, Jason.
But was my voice available when I was teaching?
Yes.
Yes.
Ah, good. I thought the whole thing is come without the no. Volume.
Voice, you would have told you otherwise.
But sir, I actually can't listen to you. Is my mic is on, everything is on.
Check your volume level. Yeah, Your volume level is okay?
Means one people to ask me questions about what can they do and all, but I couldn't listen anyone, so.
1 minute, huh? 1 minute. I'll just mute you and unmute you again.
Now, can you hear us? Check your phone. Check your phone.
Jason, you're there? That was a better idea. We can't hear you. Ma'am, you can hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. I can't hear him.
Yeah. Nothing.
Just tell him to check whether he's on device audio, right? The top left corner.
How do we tell him that's the problem?
Is it on the top left or the top right?
Right. Ma'am, little lower. Yes, ma'am.
Is it on now?
Yeah,
yes,
yeah.
It's on.
Perfect.
Okay, so we really need the recipes for the mousse, the glaze, and the ganache.
Okay, yes, ma'am. Sure, why not? So basically, the recipe for ganache is super easy. The cooking is important, okay? So I take a 1:1 for ganache. Okay, that's the way I do it. 1:1, heavy cream 1 liter, and 1 kg of chocolate, dark chocolate. Let it be a Kalidou for Belgian chocolate mousse, or let it be a Dutch chocolate mousse, or let it be a Morde for normal chocolate mousse. Okay, it's always 1:1 for me in ganache.
Okay.
So is it for all the types of chocolates, like dark, milk, and white, or it's only?
No, sir. The dark chocolate, it sets very fast.
Right.
Sets very fast because it is less of cocoa butter and lot of chocolate in it. Let it be a white chocolate, it has more of cocoa butter.
Mm-hmm.
It's a different amount. So the actually by experience you'll understand how much to put, but mostly I prefer playing with chocolate mousse because it's everyone's favorite.
Right.
So yes, but by chocolate mousse, you can say your ganache has to be super perfect. Okay, you need to boil the cream. Okay, not lukewarm it. You have to boil the cream with sugar and with just glucose in it.
Okay.
Amount of 10-20 gram of glucose or just 10 gram
wait,
of glucose.
Wait, Jason, one second.
Yes.
The ganache is 1 kilo. Of chocolate to 1 liter of cream. That is for the ganache. I can imagine that there'll be little less cream for milk and little less for white chocolate, right? Okay,
yes,
now
yes.
You're going to mousse. This
mousse.
Is now
you
mousse
must always
recipe.
To get a nice glazy ganache.
Mm-hmm.
Always use a glucose in it.
Oh, okay. How okay. much of glucose?
For example, if you're doing one, just take 10 grams, 10 or 20 grams.
Okay.
small amount is more than enough to get that glazy effect. The way you put cornstarch in the Chinese to get that glaze, the same way. When you do it for ganache.
Okay. All right.
And you have to store the ganache. You need, when you're making a mousse, okay, when you're making a mousse, the ganache has to be semi-hard.
Okay.
Always semi-hard, then you put it in the mousse. Okay.
Okay.
And one best thing of ganache is, if you put, instead of using a glaze, you can just put milk in the ganache, stir it, and you can use a chocolate sauce over it. Okay. And you can still coat the cake with it. Because as it is ganache, it will get set.
Okay.
And this is how you make truffle cakes. Chocolate truffle cake, chocolate mousse, and then ganache over it. Not glaze, just a ganache. Okay.
Okay.
And now let me, mousse, very important, the actual chocolate mousse.
Hmm.
Okay. I need to tell you the measurement as well.
Yes, please.
Okay, so the actual chocolate mousse, the measurement, I have to actually open the recipe out. Okay. Can you give me 1 minute, ma'am?
Sure. No, okay, minute, no, you come back seconds. To the glaze then. Tell me the glaze.
the glaze, okay. Sugar syrup, okay. Put 1 kg of sugar syrup.
Uh-huh.
Okay. You boil it with water, which is just put 1 kg and put 500 or at least 800 little bit here and there water.
800 ml. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Then, once the sugar is cooked sugar should not be super thick. It should not be at 121 or something. No. Normal cooking, just boiling little bit. That time you put your cocoa powder.
Okay.
Put 500 grams of cocoa powder in.
Okay.
Okay. You cook it well. Just a small 200 grams of dark compound or something.
Okay.
It's not necessary. Okay. It's not always necessary. But people who don't have gelatin.
Okay.
Like suddenly if you just run out and you get an order. That time you use your compound.
Okay.
Okay, or just cocoa powder is more than enough.
Okay.
Cocoa powder is more than enough because chocolate is made out of cocoa powder.
Okay.
Okay. So then in the end, you means if it is, just take nice 15 grams or 20 grams only, okay? Of you means is gelatin is 3:1 always.
When you say 3:1 is.
If 5 grams of gelatin, 15 grams of water.
Okay.
Okay, it's always like this.
Okay. Okay.
You soak it. Okay, you don't just put the water in the glaze and put in the glaze. No, you soak it.
Right.
You put in the microwave, you melt it or double boiler, then put in the gelatin. But it then put in the glaze what you cook.
Yes.
Set it nicely and it is the glaze. Just see to that when you, I just showed you, demonstrated how to use the glaze. Just see to that, it should not be wet.
Okay.
It cannot be wet and see to that the mousse is not melted or the glaze will never stick. If it's super hard, so it's super, super very hot, it will actually get the mousse out of the cake.
Okay.
And then destruction.
Okay.
Anything else?
All right. Melroy will ask you the other questions that have come in.
Okay, Jason, you spoke about sponge, right?
Sponge, yeah.
Yeah, so we want to know, I've got a question. Like, what is a sponge? So it's a question from one of our students. So what is a sponge?
Oh my God, a Google answer. Something you can find in Google. Question. Okay. Okay, no problem. I'll tell you one thing. So I won't give you a definition of what is in the Google, okay? Not in the book. For me, the sponge is a actual base of a cake. The most important is your sponge, okay? The only thing that you can understand between two types of sponge means not the vanilla chocolate one, no.
Right.
It's a premix and the real made, okay? Premix and real made. Premix is super easy to make. It gives a good consistency. But to master a sponge, you should know how to whip an egg white. Okay, and how to fold the flour in the egg white. Okay, sponge is, for me, for my definition, sponge is the base of a cake. A flavorful sponge, everything is upon you, how you flavor it, like cocoa powder, vanilla essence, whatsoever. For me, sponge is a base of a cake. It's a building, a building with the pillars. On this only, depending how much you put a flour, because you put more flour, it will become very hard. It will never soak the sugar syrup. Never. Okay. So, recipe is important. Just to conclude, like, what is sponge? It's just a base. And very important base for any cake.
So, now you said, I have a question. Can a sponge be eggless?
Of course.
Yeah.
Yes, of course, it is egg. It can be eggless.
Okay.
But how to make it? I use a premix one. I'm telling you, I use a premix one. There's a baking powder as well.
Okay.
So, miss, there are many things that you can use. For eggless, I prefer not making in the house, because it is very because in the industrial oven is different. You get that bhatti or rotary oven or deck oven. Okay. You are getting a different temperature. But if I use eggless over here, for sure, I'm going to ruin it. I'll be very honest on it. Get a premix eggless. Okay. And every eggless, because the premix only is the one who can give you a perfect consistency of an eggless punch.
True. So, is there any... One more question. What are the colors? What type of colors are used to make a rainbow cake?
The 7 rainbow colors.
No, what type they mean? Type means now we
type
have.
Type means using liquid or gel.
Yeah, exactly.
Ah, okay. So basically, I'm sorry, I don't know what. Okay. For liquid colors, okay, if you use liquid colors in the oil and it will vary. It will vary in the sponge. But if you use a gel color, which I recommend, it's expensive, but a small drop of gel color makes a very big difference. Okay, because gel color, if you keep using everywhere, it's very important that you can use it in the chocolate as well and a normal sponge as well. Liquid color, you can't use any. Means mostly you can use in the chocolate, sponge cakes and all. It is okay. But gel color, what I prefer.
Okay, so gel color. Okay, now we have our student, Vivina. So she wants to ask you a question. So I'll just request.
Good questions, not Google one.
No, she wants to ask you another question. She is on. Vivina, okay. You can speak.
Good afternoon, sir. I wanted to ask you, if the cake breaks when you put the mousse, how do you rectify that? Can you rectify it?
Sir, I couldn't listen. Can she be loud or something, please?
Hello?
Yes, Vivina.
Yes, Viviana, I can listen to you, but you are not that audible.
Hello?
Yes, Vivina, tell me. I'll ask you.
I wanted to ask that if the cake breaks while putting mousse, is there any way to rectify it?
Okay, Jason.
Yes.
So her question is, while layering the cake, if the sponge breaks,
okay,
can you rectify it?
Okay, while layering, best question I ever got till now, because this is the job what we do. Okay, how if you don't rectify it, like how will you use the broken sponge? Okay, it's all, if it's broken, it's broken. There's no Fevikwik or something you can stick it. Okay, so yes, when if you have a sponge, okay, and if it's a mountain sponge or something. It's very hard, like 2 minutes waste a sponge. So what we do, we take a nice proper sponge down. We put the mousse, sugar syrup, the broken sponge we put in the middle. Okay? And then we put the nice sponge on top. This is how you use a sponge which is broken. And if the whole cake hold is broken, you don't have to worry. The best sticking agent for cake is your whipped cream or mousse. Okay? You put the mousse inside a broken part of the cake, you stick it, you nicely coat it, and you put it in the freezer. It will get stuck. But one thing, when you're lifting it, you see to that, you lift in the opposite way. If the crack is like this, you don't put your palette up like this. You put your palette over like this. Because it will crack when you're lifting it. Did I answer the question?
Yes, very well.
Yes.
Very well.
Yeah. No one else. Anybody else would like to just unmute and speak? You can raise your hand as well.
No, I think... they've all asked.
Yeah.
All right. Melroy, all yours.
Yes, ma'am. All right. So, thank you very much.
Jason. Most welcome, sir.
Thank you, Jason.
Yes, we learned about piping. We learned about layering of cake. Wonderfully done in the cake ring, I would say. Especially, I love the mousse one, which was in the mold, the chocolate mousse one. Thank you, because I would tell you one thing. When people use a mold for a mousse cake, usually what people do is they only feel it's a mousse cake. So the whole cake is only with mousse.
Exactly.
You do not know that inside there is sponge. And it is important to have sponge in the middle. Exactly. Otherwise, if it's only a mousse cake, and if even though you're using a gelatin, if you leave it on room temperature, within half an hour, it will
be melting. It has to, yes.
So maximum people feel like mousse cake means only mousse. It shouldn't contain any kind of a sponge. So thank you for covering that up.
You're most welcome, sir.
Thank you very much. And you showed a couple of your skills. Amazing. Good to see you working and, you know, having your palette knife well set on your hand. But one advice I can give you is also to our students is using an offset palette knife. You get an offset palette knife.
Gives you a handle. The bent palette knife.
Exactly, a bent palette knife. So it makes things a little work easy.
Yes.
Okay.
It's very important to use a bent palette knife to lift a cake. It's very easy. But to coat a cake, you require a straight one.
A flat one. That I agree.
A flat one is the most important thing because the base, like we are in first year, the base is first year. The base for coating is a flat palette knife.
Flat palette. That's where you learn. That's where you learn. And thank you for sharing all of this. Thank you. I appreciate your time. I know you have a busy schedule at your Baker's Delight. You told me yesterday. Thank you.
Most welcome, sir. Thank you so much for having
Thank you, Jason. And you know what I loved most is I didn't know that you had different degrees of moisturing the cake, of putting the sugar syrup, that you had to have different percentages. That makes so much of sense. And it was beautifully done, and to test the cake to see how much of moisture there was.
Yes.
And also the way in which you had used your palette knife. So thank you so much, Jason. And we wish you all the success with this new venture of Baker's Delight. Okay.
Thank you so much.
From all the students and especially the new admissions who have joined you today.
Please. The best college ever.
Thank you, Jason. Can't wait to taste your cakes.